Thank you.
Physically, emotionally, and spiritually. I'm not used to talking to children. For all my years, I always talk. I dialogue with children. So I'm going to ask you some questions and see how good you can answer them, and we'll see how this works. So we're called in our two schools to be the best version of ourselves academically. We don't have to compete with anyone or compare ourselves. God just wants you, Tom, or you, Bill, or you, Joseph, or you, Mary, or you, Catherine, to be the best Catherine, the best Tom, the best Bill, the best Joe that you can be. So, what do you think? How can you be the best person academically? Well, that's a good answer. You can listen to your teachers. They allow anyone else to learn. That's a great answer. What else? Very good. You can do your homework. We do our homework to learn. It's a great way of learning. Are there any other answers you can give? Well, that's a very good answer. You can get enough sleep. You go to sleep early so your mind can be alert to learn in the best possible way academically. Okay, now how can you be the best students emotionally? That's an excellent answer. Being kind. It was a wonderful answer. I don't think there's a better quality a person can have than have kindness. Kindness trumps everything. To be kind to one another, to be kind to your teachers, for the teachers to be kind to you, for the principals to be kind to all of us, for the pastor to be kind to you. All those are the most wonderful ways to reveal Jesus. Are there anyone else out there? That's a great answer. That's a great answer. To be the best emotion, we should be able to forgive. We all mess up. While the gym voices up, teachers and principals, we all make mistakes. That's why we forgive one another, so we can have stable relationships and be the best we can emotionally. Okay, how can we be the best version of ourselves physically? That's a good answer. We can exercise. During this time, sometimes we're at home a lot. It's good to take a walk with mom or dad or someone. Put on your mask, keep your social distance. So we are called to do that. Also, what else? We can eat properly. So for example, that's a good answer. For example, if Father Jim has today a pint of ice cream, popcorn, potato chips, three chocolate bars, and then pizza for more protein. Is that a good meal? No, I wouldn't be around for much longer. I'd be seeing the doctor, or be sick. I would not be able to work. So they eat properly. You know, it's okay to have a little dessert, which is really, really fun to have, but also to eat our protein, our fish, our vegetable, our potato, to get all, you know, all the nutrients we could get, because then we could be strong physically to build ourselves up. And also, we should try during this COVID period to go out in the schoolyard or courtyard with a social distance to have a little exercise to keep moving around, or whatever else we can do, which our principals have suggested. Also, we are called to be the best students spiritually. How can we do that? Well, that's a good answer. We can pray. What could we pray? Okay, to pray in the morning, do it at school, pray at night. Or else, we could pray before and after meals. A lot of us don't do that. But thank God for the food we have shared, you know, and pray for people who don't have food. And thank God afterwards too. But bless us, our families, and our food. That's really a great way to be the best spiritually. Also, we could read the Bible, the stories, and talk about them. And then also we could live out what Christ tells us in the Gospel. For example, Father Jim read the gospel today, and it was Jesus saying to the people that your life will be judged or measured by how well you treat one another. And then he says, I was hungry, and you gave me to eat. And he said, when you do that to your brother or sister, you do it to me. So how can we help the hungry? What can we do to put our faith in action? That's a good idea. We could give some food to the poor. Also, that's even really a good answer. We have a St. Vincent de Paul Society, the Queen of Angels, St. Matthias, St. Vincent de Paul Society. We take care of the poor. We take care of people with clothing. We take care of people who can't pay their rent. All those things are really wonderful works of mercy. We could contribute to them, and our parents could contribute to them. We could also participate with them when we can have food drives in a much better fashion than we've been now. We can hand out school supplies. Last week or the week before last week, our St. Matthias, St. Vincent, Queen of Angels, St. Vincent de Paul Society, handed out school supplies outside so we'd be in the fresh air with social distance, and many families came. And they were very grateful. I stopped out there just to say hello, and they really thanked me. They were very, very grateful. So we can do all these things, academically, and physically, and spiritually, and emotionally, to be the best version of ourselves. We're called to do that. But we can't do that if we're not safe. Okay? So when we're in school or in public, what do we have to do? We have to wear a mask. And Father Jim has a really favorite mask of his right here. We'd like to show you. Do you like my mask? Yes, this is a great baseball team called the Chicago White Sox. And they're in first place, and the Cubs are in first place. But Father Jim is a Sox fan. But also, he really likes the Cubs to win, but if they play the Sox, he wants the Sox to really beat the Cubs. So Father Larry is, too, a Sox fan. So we have two Sox fans, priests with you, which is probably your double blessed. So make sure you wear your mask, and keep your social distance when you're close to people, and make sure you wash your hands. Father Jim has to wash his hands about 25 times a day. He's always with people. He's always going here and there. He has to wash before and after. I wash before Mass. I wash before there. I wash before communion. I keep sanitizing and sanitizing. And also, I try to keep my social distance and the principles and everyone here. This moment, we're all our social distance. And we're trying to be safe so that we could do the best possibility. So if one of us do get sick or whatever, you know, we try. And it's all we can do. We could try, you know, we could just limit it. So those are really some thoughts that we could share with one another in the classroom. And maybe also in the classroom we could share with your teachers more answers to besides the ones you gave me about being the best version academically, spiritually, physically, and emotionally. We could share that so we could be the best version of who God wants us to be. And be safe also at this time. God bless you. Be assured of my love, prayers, and support for our principals, the teachers, and all the students of Queen of Angels and St. Matthias Elementary Schools. Now, I'm going to give a blessing to the principals and the teachers and the students. So I invite the principals to come up here. Lord God, your spirit of wisdom fills the earth and teaches us your ways. Look upon our students of Queen of Angels and St. Matthias. Let them enjoy their learning and take delight in new discoveries. Help them to persevere in their studies and give them the desire to learn all things well. Look upon our principles. This is Katie Carton and Ms. Ronald Grimes. Look upon all our teachers and let them all strive to share their knowledge with gentle patience and endeavor always to bring the truth to eager minds. Grant that our students and teachers of Queen of Angels and St. Matthias alike may follow Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life. May Almighty God bless all of you with a much longer life, good health, and continued deep faith in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. God bless you. Good luck. We'll now have the prayers of faith.
Please respond to each petition, Lord, hear our prayer. For students, as they begin this new school year, that the Spirit of God may grant them the gifts of wisdom and understanding, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For teachers, that they may share their knowledge with gentleness, patience, and concern for their students. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For those who seek knowledge of the things of this world, that they may always pursue God's wisdom and work for justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For parents, the first teachers of their children, that their faith and love may be an example to us always. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all the sick, especially those suffering from COVID-19, that they may feel our care for them in their time of illness and receive strength from our merciful God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all who have died, especially those who died during the pandemic, that we will remember them in our prayers and comfort their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
I also ask you to pray for my dear father, Clem Kazurowski. Today is 39 years ago, he passed away and went into eternal life. We pray that he rest in peace until we see him again, a great dad. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O loving and giving and merciful God, we ask you to hear all our prayers, the ones we've shared today, those deep within our hearts. Through your beloved Son, Jesus, our light in the darkness, our hope and despair, who lives with you, in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Let us pray, my dear friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the spiritual sacrifice placed on your altar with loving devotion, and give our principals, teachers, and students a right spirit, so that their faith may make these gifts pleasing to you, and their humility commend them, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God our Father, you have brought us here together so that we can give you thanks and praise for all the wonderful things you have done. We thank you for all that is beautiful in the world and for the happiness you have given us. We praise you for the daylight and for your word, Jesus Christ, which lights up our minds. We praise you for the earth and all the people who live on it, and for our life which comes from you. We know that you are good, you love us and do great things for us, and so therefore we pray. Then we can offer to you what you have given to us. On the night before he died, Jesus was having supper with his apostles. He took bread from the table, he gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread and gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you and gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Then Jesus said to them, "Do this in memory of me." The mystery of Lord, you never forget any of your children. Remember all our children of St. Matthias and the angels. Remember everyone today who is suffering from pain or sorrow. Remember Christians everywhere and all other people in the world. We are filled with wonder and praise when we see what you do for us through Jesus, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so now we have the courage to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant me peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Let us offer that peace to one another. Behold Jesus, our light, our love, and our hope. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to this supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Oh, Lord, save.
I would first like to thank our ministers for making this Mass today possible. Kenneth, thank you so much. Ms. Brisbane and Ms. Carter, thank you so much for being here praying with us today. And we're really grateful for our principals who are doing a fantastic job. And I hope we can thank them and thank your teachers. Because when you thank your teachers for doing things for you in the principal, it's saying you love them. When they say, when they accept it, it's saying they love you back. And that's what our Christian life is all about. Also, one more thing you can do spiritually is we could go to Mass. Our Masses are not full of, they're not fully filled in church now. But I do say one Mass a week at St. Matthias on Sunday, and I say a couple of Masses here. But we also have streaming Masses. So we have a streaming Mass for Queen of Angels St. Matthias at 5 o'clock on Saturday, so you can sit at home and you could pray with your family and talk about the scripture for the homily or during the Mass and receive communion spiritually. Also, we have a Mass in Spanish. It's at 9 o'clock streaming, so if your mom and dads are speaking Spanish, you could have that Mass there. I'm celebrating those Masses for the last 25 weeks. So we'll continue to celebrate them for a pretty much longer time, maybe as long as I'm here, who knows. So I want you to have a wonderful day. I'm going to pray that all of you are going to be the best version academically, spiritually, physically, and academically that God wants you to be. And I'm going to pray that we're all going to be safe. And please pray for me that I'm safe too. That we wear our masks, keep our social distance, and sanitize our hands. God bless you and God love you. Let us pray. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the spiritual sacrifice placed on your altar with loving devotion. Lord, our God, who have been pleased to nourish us with this heavenly food, pour, we pray, the delights of your Holy Spirit into all our hearts, our teachers, principals, and students, that what they have devoutly received in time, they may possess as a gift for eternity through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May our Father's face always shine upon us. May the Son's love forever be in our hearts. And may the Holy Spirit grant us health, happiness, and peace of mind. And may Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve our Lord. Have a wonderful school year.